Sitting comfortably at the peak of the trending AI model charts is none other than Google's new open-source Gemma model. As a powerful, open, and easy-to-use LLM, it's no wonder this model is topping the charts. Today, we'll guide you through fine-tuning this model, enjoying a simple Google Colab notebook and some basic data preparation steps, all while keeping costs, GPU memory usage, and frustration at an all-time low. Before we jump straight in, let's indulge in a bit of conceptual overview. For fine-tuning Google's Gemma model here efficiently, we'll employ certain tools, Hugging Face for their Transformers library mainly, and the newer, less widespread Unsloth library. Now, you might not have heard much about the latter. It's a project by two Australian engineers set on making fine-tuning as efficient as possible. So we're going to leverage this model through both of these libraries, all within the confines of an inexpensive Colab notebook. Of course, we'll also walk you through how to easily prepare your custom data for the fine-tuning work. March ahead and join us on this journey, and before you know it, you'll be a proud custodian of a finely tuned Gemma AI model. Our dataset, encapsulating short stories and their associated summaries, will undergo a transformation into a format ready for the LLM fine-tuning. We will templatize the LLM prompt with the LLM instruction, the story, and the summarization of that story. We'll also print out a neat table of token counts. With the successful execution, you'll find your training files compiled, as well as token counts for all our stories. You can keep these token counts in mind when we later set the context window in our fine-tuning notebook. With our data prepped, let's download the training files. Our next adventure takes us to Colab, where we'll connect to a GPU. If you have relatively short training examples, the T4 model could suffice, as the models themselves take up only a few gigabytes of GPU memory. But if you need a more solid setup, perhaps for longer inputs, opt for the A100. Are you ready? Getting started here, we can actually increase the max sequence length because of the rope scaling. Let's say we want a 12K sequence length. We'll see how that goes and then scale back if required. This is a pretty high sequence length, being beyond the base model. Ensure that you select a suitable model here too. How about using, for instance, the instruct version of the Gemma model? This will give the model a strong foundation for questions answering and our summarization task. Coming next, we're layering on the QLoRA layers, and guess what? We can simply accept the defaults. The QLoRA paper advocates for an R value of 64, saying it generalizes well, but let's stick with the example value for reduced computational complexity. Next, we're customizing the example notebook data, loading to use our own data as opposed to a public Hugging Face dataset. We're compiling the instructions, inputs, and outputs right here, then saving them as a dataset object. Now let's roll up our sleeves and see if we can train this model. The main twist here is adding a save strategy of steps and saving every 25 steps. This is your golden ticket to check out a specific checkpoint of the model. This can be helpful when striking the right balance between loss and overtraining without the need to retrain the model. Unfortunately, we have an out-of-memory error, so let's reduce the context window just a touch and rerun our fine-tuning cells. All right, much better. Again, select a number of steps or a training checkpoint that gives you a sweet spot of loss versus overtraining. This will require hundreds of steps if you've prepared a proper fine-tuning dataset of at least 100 or 2 examples. Now we'll use our regular instruction format and provide a story that we intentionally kept out of the training set. We get this beautiful response that lays everything out, our instruction, our story, and our summary. Now, this notebook does offer some extra features like saving your adapter layers or even saving the merged model as a whole on Hugging Face. That'll give you a nice hub to pull your model from in your pipelines, scripts, APIs, and applications. For your convenience, we'll add the diagram file as well as the Python code in the description of this video. Huge thanks for sticking around, and please enjoy responsibly.